As an advanced medical practitioner and pharmacist practicing in family medicine, I definitely know how wearing the wrong cuff size and wearing your blood pressure cuff incorrectly can give inaccurate blood pressure readings and significantly impact your health negatively. So, in this video, I'm going to share with you 5 of my top tips all about picking the right cuff size, measuring your arm, how to wear it, where to wear it, and also a bonus tip all about temperature and how it affects blood pressure, one thing that not a lot of people know about. So here's a fact. Studies have shown that using a blood pressure cuff that's too small for you can actually overestimate your systolic blood pressure by 5 to 20 millimeters of mercury. And on the other hand, using a cuff that's too large can underestimate it by about 3.6 millimeters of mercury. So this basically means that if we're getting inaccurate blood pressure readings like this because our cuff size is not right, then it can lead to inappropriate medication being prescribed or not prescribed, and also increasing your risk of these cardiovascular health events. Now, whilst we're on this topic, I actually had a patient which I had this exact same issue with. He provided 7-day home blood pressure readings. On average, his home blood pressure readings were about 15 millimeters of mercury higher than what I was getting in the office here. When I checked his blood pressure monitor, because I asked him to bring it in, I noticed that his cuff size, so the cuff was too small, and it was basically overestimating his blood pressure. If I didn't check this, this might have resulted in an incorrect diagnosis of hypertension. Okay, so it's critical that your cuff size is correct. Now, thankfully, many of our A&D medical blood pressure monitors come equipped with advanced cuff detection and movement detection to ensure that you get those reliable results. And I guess whilst we're speaking about my patient's story, I think if you think about it as well, if his blood pressure cuff was too big, it'd be the flip side with it. It would be underestimating his blood pressure readings. So his actual blood pressure might be higher, which might have meant that I wouldn't have given him treatment or diagnosed him with hypertension, you see. So cuff size is so important. And now we're going to go through everything that you need to do to make sure your cuff size is right, you're wearing it right, and you're getting accurate readings. Okay, so step number one, let's begin with finding your correct cuff size. You're going to need a measuring tape to begin with, okay? First of all, we're going to find our midpoint, okay? So the way we do this is we measure from the bony bit on the top of our shoulder. This is called the acronion process, so you might want to Google that to get the exact position, all the way to our elbow, okay, which is known as the olecranon process, okay? So you measure from here to here, you divide it in by 2, and that is your midpoint, basically. So that's how you work out your midpoint. Step 2, now that we find our midpoint, we're going to get our arm circumference, okay? So I'm going to wrap this round. This is my midpoint that I've already calculated over here. And I'm wrapping it around my arm. My arm is about 12 and a half inches, okay? So now let's look at the A&D Medical blood pressure cuff table, okay? I'm gonna bring it on screen. So remember, my arm circumference was 12 and a half inches. So looking at the arm circumference table on screen right now, my arm will fit the standard wide range adult. So that's 8.6 to 16 and a half inches. So the good news here is that most of our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors come with the standard wide range cuff, like this one in my hand. So given my measurement, this will fit me perfectly. It's also worth mentioning we have the small and large adult cuffs. They will fit our other machines as well. But if you need the extra large blood pressure cuff, then please note that that cuff is only compatible with our UA789AC device. Straight on step number 3, positioning your cuff correctly, okay? If you don't position your cuff correctly, it's basically not going to be able to detect the vibrations and measure your blood pressure correctly and accurately, okay? So this is my best way that I always tell patients, extend your arm out like so, palm facing up, all right? I'm just going to pull up the cuff to the right position. You want it to be about 2 fingers from where your elbow is, okay? So 2 fingers from there, and close it tight enough so that you can fit just about 2 fingers in there snugly, okay? If you're able to fit any more than that, it's probably not tight enough, okay? So that's a good thing to remember. Now, one other thing to note is that some of our A&D medical blood pressure monitors actually come with advanced cuff fit detection, like this one in my hand that I'm using right now. It's the UA910BLE. This can be really useful because if your cuff isn't fitting right, if it's too loose, it will come up with the advanced cuff detection warning. Straight on step number 4, it's all about aligning your cuff correctly, okay? So we've placed it correctly, or is it aligned correctly, okay? Now, our A&D medical cuffs all come with this white dot, okay? This white dot needs to be aligned with your middle finger, okay? If it's not, the cuff isn't going to be able to detect those vibrations and to get your blood pressure correctly, accurately, okay? Other blood pressure monitors have different things. Ours all come with this white dot, so always make sure you're doing that. Another thing that I thought I'd tell you about is a patient story, actually. This one happens quite often, and it's patients wearing the cuff the wrong way around, okay? So this white dot should always be pointing down, all right, on the bottom side. But a lot of times I see patients trying to put in on a cuff the wrong way around. So they'll have this white dot, you know, upwards instead of down here, all right? And I've seen that happen many times. And to be quite honest, it's actually really hard to even close the cuff if you put it on the wrong way. But just bear that in mind that you're doing that correctly, because we don't want inaccurate readings. Also, another point to bear in mind, when you've got your cuff on and you're doing your blood pressure reading with this tube, always run it down your arm, okay? And then connect it to your blood pressure monitor, okay? I've seen patients do it a lot of times where it goes underneath their elbow and then it's obviously getting pushed on a table and is blocking the tube, so it's going to give inaccurate readings. So always just run it along the arm like so and connect it to your blood pressure monitor. Easy as that. Moving straight on to step number five, here's one that a lot of people don't know about, and it's about temperature, okay? Temperature can affect your blood pressure readings, okay? Colder temperatures can cause our blood vessels to constrict, which is gonna temporarily increase our blood pressure, okay? So this is really important to think about, that if you've come from a really cold environment and you've come home, give yourself time to get acclimatized to the temperature in the room, okay? Same applies as well if the outside is really hot and you've come home, okay? And also, making sure that your house is always a bit of a constant temperature. Now, what I really love about our A&D Medical blood pressure monitors is we are obviously aware of this, and we've already made updates on our blood pressure monitors to record this. So this one in my hand here is the UA910BLE, and it actually records the ambient room temperature when you're taking your blood pressure reading. That way you have a better understanding of any outliers in your readings. Our technology is designed to give you even more confidence in your health tracking. So next up, here's my pro tip for making sure that the blood pressure monitor that you're using at home is clinically validated for accuracy and on the validated device list, which we call VDL for short. This is by the American Medical Association, Hypertension Canada, and the British and Irish Society of Hypertension. Because believe me, a lot of the blood pressure monitors that you can buy on Amazon are not on the validated device list, so they're not accurate. And I've personally been using A&D Medical's blood pressure monitors in my very own practice for years, because one, they're an absolute workhorse when it comes to blood pressure monitors, and two, they're clinically validated for accuracy by the organizations I mentioned earlier by performing formal studies. And as the inventors of the digital home blood pressure monitor back in 1977, A&D Medical definitely know what they're doing when it comes to blood pressure monitors. Now, to learn more about A&D Medical and their wide range of medical devices, definitely do check out the link in the description below. We're committed to helping you stay healthy with reliable products that you can trust. And best of all of our blood pressure monitors come with a 5-year warranty if you're in the US, UK, or Canada. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really hope that you found this information helpful. We do have more videos on the channel, like how to use your blood pressure monitor correctly, going through it step by step, natural ways to lower your blood pressure, and some really interesting videos that we have on different myths, debunking them and putting them to the test and seeing exactly how they alter and affect your blood pressure. So that's a real good watch. I really hope you found this information helpful. And as we always say at the end of every video, A&D Medical, discover precision.